Happy morning, children. I hope you are all safe and fine. You all had your breakfast? Okay, children. Now we are going to start a new lesson. So for the term 1, we had completed up to chapter 6. And for term 2, we have seen one lesson also, that is weather, climate and adaptation of animals to the climate. Now we are going to see the next. So can anyone tell me what is that lesson, children? Chapter 8? No, we are not going to see chapter 8, we are going to see chapter 15. We are going to see chapter 15, okay? So this lesson also will be interesting for you, okay children? So look at here, I have given you some clues to find what is the title of that lesson. These are all the clues for you to find the title of the lesson. What is this? Sunlight. Here, color lights. What is this? Light. So, whether you all guessed the answer? Very good. So, the lesson is light. What is that? Chapter 15? Light. Children, listen carefully. This lesson is a vast lesson. This lesson is vast lesson. It may take 2 to 3 weeks to complete. It can take more 2 weeks, more than 2 to 2 weeks to complete. So follow the lesson regularly without skipping the video. Watch the class, okay? If you start skipping the video, you are not able to understand any concept. Okay, children? I hope you would have understood. You will follow it. But you are ready with your hints note? Again and again I am telling you, be ready with and sit with your hints note. Without your hints note, don't sit. Okay? Sit with your hints note. Write chapter 15, light, today's date. So this lesson is vast lesson. I am going to tell you more content which is not there in your book. Okay? So this lesson, the basic of this lesson, you have studied in your 6th standard. In your grade 6, you have studied the basic of this lesson. So what is the title which you studied at the 6th standard? It is light, shadows and reflection. In your 6th standard, you have studied as light, shadows and reflections. Okay, children? Now we are going to start this lesson with basic. I am going to start you from the basic. So don't miss anything. Keep watching. Okay? So these are all the content of this lesson. These are all the content of this lesson. The first one is introduction, definition of light, properties of light. Up to this you will be not having nerve. These are all the basic. So, note down each and every point which I am telling you. Okay? And then, light travels along a straight line, reflection and image, loss of reflection. This loss of reflection is not there in our book, but it's very much important concept while reading about light. This is very much important while reading light. And then, types of reflection. These two topics are not there, but they are very much important. And then spherical mirror, concave and convex mirror, real and virtual image, image formed by lenses, last sunlight, and we'll have a recap. So in today's session, we'll be seeing the first three topics, that is introduction of light, definition of light, and then properties of light. These are all the three topics which we are going to see. So, have you all noted the title of that lesson? Right, introduction. Shall we start, children? So, keep watching. If you have any doubts, then and there clarify your doubts with me. Okay? Don't wait. Then and there clarify your doubts with me. Okay, children? So, introduction. What is the main source of light? What is the main source of light? Yes, I can guess your answer. Sunlight. Sunlight is the main source of light. And heat. Sunlight is the main source of light and heat. Other than this, we have some other sources of light. They are candle, torch. So sunlight is the natural source of light, and these are all the artificial or man-made sources. Natural source, artificial or man-made source. Okay. Star is also a natural source. Okay, children. So next is the definition of light. Without light, can you able to live? So light is responsible for everything. So if there is no light, feel how the earth would be. If there is no light, all the days or night, how it would be? You'd feel jolly, right? Sleeping all the days. Yes or no? So whether it is possible for us to sleep daily? No. So light is important for the heat. Mainly we get heat from the earth. If there is no heat, we'd freeze. We'd become freezed. We'd become ice. Okay? And then, what is mean by light? It is a definition of light. Note it down, children. Light, or we can call light as visible light. Light or visible light commonly refers to electromagnetic radiation. Note this. Light or visible light commonly refers to electromagnetic radiation. So we can call this as electromagnetic radiation. I'll tell you what is mean by electromagnetic radiation. Okay. Electro means what? What is mean by electro, children? Electric field is there. Magnetic means magnetic field is there. So light has both electric field and magnetic field. What is it? Listen carefully, children. We can call light, or we can call it as visible light. We can call it as light. Otherwise, we can call it as visible light. So it is called as electromagnetic radiation. Light is called as EM waves. EM is nothing but electromagnetic. Electromagnetic radiation that can be detected by our human eye. We are able to see the light. Okay, children? Electromagnetic is nothing but it has both electric field and magnetic field in it. If electric field is there, magnetic field is created. If magnetic field is there, electric field will be created there. So they consider electric and magnetic field as twins. Consider electric and magnetic field as twins. So it is called, light is called as electromagnetic radiation. So we are able to see the light. Look at here, children. I said you right. Sun is the main source of light, and we have some other sources of light also, which helps us to see the objects during night time. Okay. Next, we have two different sources of objects. The first one is luminous objects. Note it down. Luminous object. What do you mean by luminous objects? The objects which emits their own light is called as luminous objects. What is it? The objects which emits its own light is called luminous object. So the example is stars and the lights which is there in the pipe. They emit their own light. They have their own light. Okay. So the objects which emit their own light are called as luminous objects. And then non-luminous objects. The objects which do not emit their own light is called non-luminous objects. What is it? The objects which do not emit their own light is called as non-luminous objects. Look at here. Example, moon. I have given you moon as an example. Moon does not has its own light, children. Don't think moon as a luminous. Moon does not has any light power in it. Moon absorbs the light from the sun and emits it. Moon absorbs the light from the sun and emits that light. So moon is not a luminous source, it is a non-luminous source. It absorbs from the others and gives out. And then earth. So how can we say that earth is a non-luminous? Whether earth produces its own light? No, we are able to see the earth. Consider we are on top, we are in some satellites, etc. Okay, we are in some spacecraft. Whether we are able to see from the spacecraft or earth without the sun. If sun is not there, whether we are able to see the earth? No. So, the earth receives the light from the sun and emits. That is why we are able to see that. But sun, if it is daytime also we are able to see. If it is nighttime also, the sun keeps on emitting its light. Yes or no? But the objects around us, consider this mouse. Consider this mouse, children, whether it emits its own light? No. So we are able to see this mouse during daytime. Whether in the night, without light, whether we are able to see this? Whether it is possible to see the objects which is around us during night without light? It is not possible. So these objects absorb the light and emits. That is why we are able to see them. Okay? So the light falls on these objects. So these objects absorb that light and emit that. That is why we are able to see them. If there is no light, they will not absorb, and there is no emission, we are not able to see. Okay children, I hope up to this you would have understood what is mean by light, luminous objects and non-luminous objects. Okay, tell me some other examples of luminous and non-luminous. So, if you have your note, note down these in your note. Luminous, you write some other examples for luminous. Write few examples for non-luminous also. Okay children, now look at here, I am giving you a small activity. So, classify luminous and non-luminous objects. Okay, tell me whether this firefly, right? It is a luminous or non-luminous object, children. Whether this firefly is an insect used to emit light, right? Whether it is a luminous or non-luminous? If your answer is luminous, very good. So, it emits its own light. Okay? A second one, building. It is a non-luminous. In the night time, we are not able to see that if light is not there. Okay, so it is a non-luminous. It do not emit its own light. This table, yeah, this is also an example of non-luminous object. And then fire. Yes, during burning, the firewoods, the wooden logs emits its own light. So this is a luminous source. So this lantern, yeah, this is also a luminous source. And tree, this is a non-luminous. So try to write few more examples for this. Okay children? And the next thing which we are going to see is properties of light. So up to this, write down and write the next topic as properties of light. So this basics you would have studied in a 6th standard. So I am giving you this again. From the next class, we will enter into a subject. Without knowing the basic, you are not able to understand the concepts which is there in the lesson. So try to understand all this. Okay? We have seen the definition of light. Now we are going to see the properties of light. Totally we have 8 properties here. How many? Sorry, 7 properties here we have. They are reflection, refraction, diffraction. Try to spell it out, okay? Because these words may be new to you. So, practice these spellings and pronunciation. Reflection, refraction, diffraction, interference, polarization, dispersion and scattering. So these